Raksh here. Welcome back to Explore New Every Day. So today we are going to be making a sword. Whoa, sword at last. So to make a sword, you need 6 pages maximum. 4 pages for this outer part and 2 pages for the holding and designing part. So let's start, guys. So first, simply we'll fold the page into half. And remember, to make this sword, you need 6 pages, scissors and glue. Now we have to fold this page into half again. Unfold it. Fold this page into half, unfold it. And then bring this part here and this part here. So you need to only apply one time glue. Because if we take it for real, you need to do so many layers, right, to apply the glue. So this is a simple way to apply only one strap of glue. So I'll put glue right here. I'm putting glue slowly because if I do little bit mistake also, the glue will touch the other pages, which will result in sticking each other without instructions. Now we have put glue here. Glue, you can't see but I can see. Now we'll fold it. Yeah, fold it. You better use tape for this, but I'm using glue. I use glue and then I made one like this. Then this part, right, you should try to open it like this. You should open it. You should don't open only, like don't cut it and open. Just like make it like this, see. Don't do like fufu, don't do like that. Just bend your hand a little bit and then try to make it little bit like that. The secret is simple. I have put glue only in the edges. So now we have to make 2 pieces like this. Only 2. To make this sword little bit longer. 2. So guys, I have made 2 like this. Now you have to stick them like this with tape. I was mentioning tape. I also forgot to say that we need tape also. I'm using masking tape. Because my plain tape is not working. Working means it's over. Sorry. So now we will put half of the masking tape here. Please use plain tape, because if you use plain tape, it will be like you didn't do anything. It's just a long one. It's like you use a chart paper. And then cut it like this. Good. Make a masking tape like this. And then voila. You have such a long thing. And just open this little bit. Open. Good. Now if we do like this, this sword, it is like bending, right? It's like bending. So how should we avoid that? Simple. Take one page, roll it. I'll show you how. So you need 2 rolls like that. Means you know, right? You have to roll it and then it will come to the top and put glue over there. You need 2 like that, and then I'll tell you the rest. I was talking about these like that. I was talking about these type of rolls. Now we have to sword this and the roll. So what shall we do now? Now, simple. First, we'll make it straight. So we will cut this part. Small part. And then we'll get the good one for the second one. Okay. Yep. Now. This is there. Okay. Now we have to take a small part of it and put glue over there. Yeah, you have to put glue here and then take it here. Wait for a little bit to dry. Okay guys, so till it gets dry, I want to tell something. Wait till it gets dry. First thing, that I'm sorry I didn't upload videos for a while. Second thing, I made a video on how to use a sword, and this sword is not like that one sword, it's another sword which is more powerful than that one. And that much. It's not dry yet. Oh, it's dry. Yeah, it's dry. Good. This glue which I have right here, it's faster for drying. Now we have to do the simple thing. Take the sword, I told you to open it, and then in that hole put this thing inside. Yes. Good. Put it inside. Yes. Put it inside. And now it's so powerful. Like you can hit someone like this. So powerful, man. It's really very powerful. Very, very appreciable. Yeah. So now, we need 7 pages. Sorry. We need 7 pages. Oh, okay. So now, we'll take another page and make one more hole like that. But we don't need to, not hole, roll. Roll. And then, we don't need to, we need only one more. And then, I will show you what to do. Guys, do you know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking that if when this sword is made, then can we play with this sword? Absolutely, we can play. I was just fooling. Or kidding. Yes, good. So now we made one hole. So now we'll simply put it a little bit inside with the second one. We'll put it inside. Oh my god, goodness me. Goodness me, it's like stuck so hard. Yeah. Because if you do it from the other side, I'll cut this part. Yes. Because if you do it from the other side, then we actually glued the other one also, no? So it's blocking its way. So how much it is? It's very okay. So now we'll make the holding part to hold the strong sword. Oh my god. Okay. So it is strong, very strong. Yes, it's very strong. So now we have put this inside. So now we have to do one simple thing to make this sword more stylish. We can do this. We can simply cut it a little bit. Yes, we can simply cut it a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, good. So now we'll take the shorter part, means like we'll take this part of this paper and then put it inside from where this roll starts, and then start folding it like this. I show you. See, you should first fold it like this and then continue. And then don't glue it right there. I'll tell you what to do. You can glue to complete this, But don't glue it to the sword yet. We have to do something else also. So now we are done. We should take it out. The extra part I have, I'll put it down. And now we will follow this by folding it. Yes. We'll first unfold that thing so that we'll get some mark. From that mark we can start to fold. Good. So now we are going to be putting glue in the end. I made a video on how to use a crossbow, which I liked it. I played with it with my sister, of course not with my friends, because you know, it's Corona. So now we'll do the end part like this. Yes. Now if you have an extra part, you can cut it. I have little bit extra part, I'll cut it off. Because it is a perfect one we need. So now we need to see if it goes inside this. Yeah, it's going. It'll go like this. And then your sword will be like this. You're not able to understand which one is the hitting part and which one is not. So, after the sword is done, you can do one thing also. You should see. Like for example, where if we want this holding grip also to be strong, you can do one thing. You first put the sword, touch it from where you feel that it's not there, the rod is not there, start folding that part. For me, if only this part has rod, the other part is totally empty. So I'm going to cut that part because I don't want any loose part in this. I want everything tight. I want the gripping part tight. I want the gripping part tight. I want everything tight. Yeah. Now if you, the holding grip is now very tight. So now to make sure that there is a holding grip, you need color tape. Color tape. Where should we start? I don't use color tape much, but I have many, and these are brand new ones. I'm going to pause the video and search this part because I don't want to exceed the video too much. It took me a couple of minutes to find this, but I found it. It's like this. So we got to open it. And then we have to remove this part and start putting the color tape in whichever design you like. I'm going to put it in a very simple design. I'm going to show it to you. Yes. The simple design is I'm going to cover it. Simple. Because we need some of the part white, we can keep it to make it more designable and superb. So we'll just take a white and color tape. If you want, you can use a color paper also, because that is the most easiest way. But I'm going to use this. If you have only white paper, this is only the opportunity. Also, you'll never get which is the grip, and you might start playing with the sword, with the knife part only. Just a little bit awkward, but if you take color tape, then it will be good. This thing has also been a little bit heavy, yes. We'll leave a little bit white part, yes. And now we'll cut it. Okay. So I made it in a very simple way. I just covered it. That is very simple. So now I'm going to put it inside this. Wait. I have to put it from here, not from there. Yes, I made it. Yes. So now it's looking like a sword, right? So now we'll open little part of it and then we'll put glue from where you want the stand. I'll put glue at the end of the bleeding part, or you can call it a knife. After this, we have to wash my hands. Okay, so I've put glue. Now I have to again put the in it back its place, and then your sword is almost done. Not done, almost done. Guys, I forgot to tell you one thing, that from now onwards, this is my last paper video. Say farewell to paper. From now onwards, we are going to make stationary items like this crossbow I have it right here, and other things. If you guys are wondering that I didn't even make a video on how to use a sword, you guys are totally wrong. I actually already made, before making the thing only, I made a different one. Not the same, a different one. But this one is a little bit different. The everything is same, but the holding part is different. So now we'll take one last page. One more page. Wow, this is a perfect one. I will put it here. One last page. Fold it into half like this. Yeah. It's been 60 minutes for the video. I'm really sorry for that. Next time I'll not exceed it more than 15 minutes. Yeah. I will fold it into half. Yes. Now we'll unfold it. And then we'll cut. We need only one part of this. You can use the other part for anything you want. For like, you can use the other part for the, you can use, if you took extra pages, you can use the extra pages for a really cool thing. For the opening of this super long sword. That will be a very cool thing. So now we have to fold this page into half. And then not cut it. Don't cut it. And then we'll again fold it into half. If you guys are thinking that after I fold it, I should cut it, you're wrong. Please don't cut it. And then again, one last time, cut it. And then you're done. And then take glue and stick it from all the parts. There's only three sides. One, two. From now onwards, actually, I use glue in a special way. I put the glue in a paper. Means I take a paper and then I put a whole lot of glue on that. And then wait a second. I really have to wash my hands. My hands became so sticky. Actually before, in this day only, I had made one previous video how to make a crossbow. Don't think that I again wore the same t-shirt, means like tomorrow, the next day also I wore the same t-shirt, like I didn't take, but you're totally wrong. That crossbow video I've made in the day in which I'm making this sword. So now you can take any pencil. I'll take a pen. And then, wait a second. Wait. There is something here. Okay guys, so that was just a silly cockroach. I don't know how cockroaches came here. Just fooling. It could be a cockroach because I didn't call anybody to see it. Could be. But I don't know what is that. It's okay. So now we have put glue in this. No part should be open. Everything should be like closed. Now we come to the end of the video. Not means like I'm not going to end the video, means like the end of the video means we are coming to the end of making this sword. Okay, so now end of making this sword means we are almost at the end, like a movie end, you know, like something happened like that. We are almost at the end to make. Now you have to put a line like this. I'll show you. If you don't have a scale, you can use it, you can use this also. But For now, I don't have a scale, so I'll just use this pen, which is okay. If I do little bit teda meda lines, sometimes I talk Hindi with English, then it's okay, I'm sorry. Okay. Yeah. So you have to mark it like this. Mark it like this. Then make one line here. I'll show you. Make one line here. And then make one line like this. I'm thinking that from the next video, I make like a song. With the video, I make a song. So now. That was just a breeze. In a puffer house, there are many plants, no? So they just move and make me scared. Good. Actually, I noticed that some parts of my square were open, so we have to not let it do that. My hands are literally dirty, so I'm just rubbing them down the table. So now we have to put one point here. Wait. I put one big one. We have to. Wait. We have to make a diamond shape like this. 2, 3, 4. And then. We have to connect it. Good. Super. Now, you have to fold this from like this. You have to fold it like this. If you do it like this, then it's wrong. Like, do it like this. Fold it like this. And then, while folding, you will get like this, right? You'll get some sort of like this. You should cut it that part. Simple, cut that part. This, I put glue. You'll take little bit like efforts to do it because it's little bit gluey from the inside, right? So to, so you will get like this. I'll make it little bit more big. Little bit more big. You should actually use a scale for this. And use a scale only. Because if you use normally, then it will become all irregular. From one side it will be like some other. From the other side it will be like some other. Yes. So you will get like this one circle. Good one. So now take this beautiful sword. And then put this circle inside this. If it's not fitting, you can simply fold it and make one little bit more bigger one. I'm going to do that now. Because it's literally not fitting it. Okay, so I'm going to start cutting from here. Because this part was a little bit irregular from the other one. Yeah, good. Now, we're going to cut it from this part too. Or if you can do one more thing. Now it is, you have a hole like this, you can simply make it bigger by doing it one cut. Good. So now we'll make a bigger one like this and then put it in. Yes, good. Now it's going inside. Now you should put it inside till this part. Till the holding part only, put it inside. No need to do it more. And your swatch is done. A super good, powerful and nice good swatch. I was going to delete it, but it's so cool. So cool. Just love it. I'll go a little bit back. So this is going to be a sword after making it so cool. You can show. So that is the end of my video. Hope you like my channel. Subscribe to it. Hit the bell icon. Smash that like button. Bye bye. Have a nice day. And play with this sword and crossbow. Bye bye.